Hello and welcome to journalism.co.uk. This year, many reporters, like myself, have been stuck indoors working from home because of the coronavirus pandemic and lockdown, but not all of us. Some reporters have had to brave the streets in order to cover their beats, and the one that really comes to mind are those that have covered the political events of 2020, and the biggest example being last month's US presidential election. But in the year of the coronavirus pandemic, it's been a bit trickier for the media to cover these events, what with social distancing measures and the risk of infection. Nico Piro is a special correspondent for Italian broadcaster Rai, also known as RAI, and he was out in the States covering all the rallies. Nico, thanks for joining me. What has it been like covering elections when there is a global pandemic to contend with?
It's very complicated. I have to tell you that honestly, is one of the most challenging assignment I have ever had, because I had the background of a World War correspondent. I was in Bergamo and all over Italy at the peak of the first wave of epidemic. But I have to say that in the US it's another story, because too many people put you at risk. Mask has become a political statement, not what just is. I mean, a piece of clothes to help stopping the spreading of the virus. They wear no masks and they are proud of that. So honestly, the Trump rally, I went to two Trump rallies and was very challenging, because we have 5,000-6,000 people, one on the top of the other, screaming, no masks, and also, and I have to say that at the same time, having a mask in a certain way put you under a bad light, so it's more complicated to interact with people, because it's like you are an enemy. I mean, you are a slave of the system, you are supporting the big conspiracy, and it's a multi-layered situation, and was complicated.
So how did it help being a mobile journalist in that situation?
It was super interesting for basically two reasons. One practical reason is the fact that, unfortunately, Donald Trump campaign my personal opinion, but don't like foreign journalists. Don't like journalists at all, but foreign journalists in particular. I did the same thing I did a couple of times in 2016. This is not a copyright event. I'm not breaking any law. We are not talking about a football match or Champions League or MotoGP, whatever. But this is democracy. So you can't stop me, prevent me from doing my job. So I signed up as a general public. I got my ticket and I went in with my phone and I did my job. Whatever makes the guards suspicious is the fact that you have long lenses. A phone is a phone, or an Osmo mobile is an Osmo mobile. It's nothing. So we went in and we did our job. I mean, it was I felt very, very empowered by that. I had another weapon, and I could use it. Was a concealed weapon and worked. I covered two big rally of Donald Trump, and honestly was even better than being, because all these rallies, there is a fixed a confinement for the press. It's called Razor. You are up. It's also called the pen, okay? Like pig pen. And it's better because you are confined up there. Let's be honest. If you want to take those 15 seconds, 30 seconds of Trump statement, excerpts from the speech, you have Reuters, you have EBU, you have France Press, you have AP. But being in the middle of the people, understanding their feelings, understanding why they feel betrayed by the other party and so on, even listening to people who tell you the craziest conspiracy theory, this is why we are on the field. In Rome or you in London, we can have the same excerpt of the Trump speech I can have from the press razor up there. What I can have on the ground, being in the middle of people, is something, priceless.
Is there any one standout moment that you are particularly proud of, or one that really epitomizes what it's like to be a mobile journalist covering elections?
when Joe Biden, when at 11:26 of Saturday, Saturday after the day of the vote, AP called the victory of Biden. In a minute, from the streets of New York, I began listening, honking, and people screaming, and people went out of on the windows, on the balconies, and they were screaming. And in a few minutes, we were at the Trump Tower, and people began gathering there. But then the police created a security perimeter, so basically the crowd had to leave. And we went to Columbus Circles, and it was a huge gathering. But I don't want to be too emphatic, but it was like the end of the war. First of all, because New York nowadays is not the city, we know, it's a ghost town. Considering how crowded it was now because of smart working, no tourism, it's literally empty because it's also a big city. So especially in the last 7 days was hell, was crazy. That night from Times Square, I did like four lives a piece. And I was up from 4 o'clock in the morning to cover my 12 o'clock Italian time bulletin, 2:20 p.m. News bulletin, and 7 p.m. news, and was never ending. So it was good to be a team. So I was in a more traditional setup because I had my cameraman. Was a small light ENG crew. And I think this can be a good model for many colleagues who don't want to put on their shoulders the weight of being also video reporters. I think can be a middle ground, because when you are with the cameraman, but you have your phone and you know how to use your phone, that's the most important thing. You have the chance of producing outputs for social media and to help your cameraman to be like, or be the only cameraman in case of the Trump example I gave you. And so it's and also considering LumaFusion, considering the mobile editing, you can also edit while your cameraman is driving.
And do you have a single best mojo trick of the trade that you can share with us for covering elections using your mobile phone?
The most difficult aspect in an election is endurance. You are out at 8 o'clock in the morning. You start planning for the next day while you are going out to cover the things you are scheduled for the present day. Then you have to do a lot of logistics about how can I be back in time to edit my piece. Where midway I can stop to have a nice background, which makes sense to have my life. When the time will be good for Italy, where I physically be to have my Facebook life. And have I enough pictures for Instagram? Which kind of post you want to do for Facebook today? So it's about endurance. So I think that endurance is not just for you as for your body and your mind, it's for your equipment. So battery packs, they are never enough, and cables, they are never enough. I mean that a bag is a good thing to have, of course. I have a bag with a lot of stuff in it, but I had a multi-pocket jacket, and military style, standard. I know what's in this pocket, what's in this other pocket. I can go blindfolded. And in one pocket, I had the essential, which means battery pack, a cable, ND filters, and an Osmo pocket. So I am ready to shoot every time.
Hope that was useful for everyone at home as well. If you've got any more tips to share with us on covering elections or anything else mojo related, you can get in touch with us on Twitter @journalismnews. Until next time.